signed for £200,000 from Portsmouth a month ago and bringing to the team experience gained also at Manchester United. And Dundee United have been unable to obtain a work permit for the new Argentinian striker Victor Ferreira in time for this match. And with young Christian Daly unfit, Hamish French joins Duncan Ferguson in attack, hoping that young Billy McKinley can maintain the quality supply of service on midfield he demonstrated last week at Ibrox. And at the back, one of United's finest servants, David Neary, will have a key role. Now 35, the Scotland international has overcome a serious back injury to resume a career which now spans 18 seasons and earn him 33 caps. And the referee this afternoon is Louis Thau from Ayr, a 45-year-old in his 14th season as a Grade 1 official. He's a chartered quantity surveyor. Scott Crabb with a protective covering on his right wrist. Involved at the start, there he is again, challenged in midfield by McKinley. The free kick goes to United. So another hazardous match this for Hearts after their splendid start to the season. 13 points from 7 matches. United stuttering somewhat with 7 points on their 7 matches. Here's Graham Hawke's first contribution, doing a marking job there on Hamish French. So the new defensive setup for Hearts allows Hogg and Levine to do the marking with McPherson, the sweeper. That's Hogg again with the clearance. Dundee United, though, blessed by the return to the midfield of Jim McInally after injury, providing that work rate and determination which is so vital to United, alongside the silkier skills of Billy McKinley. There's McKinley again, number 8 for United, and pulled down very heavily there by John Miller. Referee Thau right on the scene there, no damage done to McKinley, but it was a very hefty challenge indeed. So United playing against the driving rain, and against the wind, and appearing to be determined to carry the fight to the league leaders. There's McKinley. Looking for Duncan Ferguson. A very awkward one this for Henry Smith in the wind. He did well enough, helped there by John Miller's clearance. Well, it's a very business-like start this by Dundee United. That's Freddie van der Hoorn, he'll take the throw. John Clark dropping deep. Give Alan Main an early touch. Well, the playing surface appears to be in excellent condition, although the rain will make it a little bit treacherous. Judge the pace of the ball coming off the surface. That's a good ball played on by McKinley after a hefty challenge again from John Miller, who's been given a marking role clearly on McKinley. There's Derek Ferguson. The pass back finds Henry Smith. Ferguson expected to do a similar role, I think, for Hearts as McKinley will do for Dundee United, two number eights with key roles. That came off the head of David Neary, and Henry Smith wind assisted, getting lots of distance. Here's Penny. Deflected by Malpass, and cleared by McKinley. Here's Gary Mackay. That's good play. Now Robertson. Looking for Crabb, the challenge came from Clark. Well, Steve Penny showing early on his willingness to be involved in the attacking action for Hearts. There's Robertson. Put in high by Mackay. That was Tosh McKinley in there, and the first time shot came from John Robertson. Well, he really is deadly with both feet around the box. It was a good challenge here in the first place by Tosh McKinley, which set up the chance here on the volley for Robertson, and that wasn't far away. Ball was dummied there by Duncan Ferguson, hoping he could release Gary Bolan over there on the left. Brave header on there by Penny. Neary was in the way. Good skill shown by Duncan Ferguson, but he's crowded out in the end. This is Gary Mackay. Past the 400 mark in matches played competitively for Hearts. Number five there. So you see the distance here Smith gets. Didn't quite catch that one the way he intended. Come back by Miller for Mackay. And that determined tackle by Malpass missed. The referee wasn't happy about it though. Thought it was a shade reckless, so he's given the free kick to Hearts. Penny playing it on. There's Crabb. Robertson helping it through there for Dave Ferguson. And what a great chance it was for Hearts. That was brilliant play in attack. Derek Ferguson finishing up with an excellent shooting opportunity. The high ball played forward there. Look at the exchange here. Crabb to Robertson. On there to Derek Ferguson. Under threat all the way though from Freddie van der Hoorn. And that's what put him off. And the crowd huddling into all covered areas of the stadium. As much as they possibly can. The rain is now so heavy that visibility has worsened considerably. I reckon the floodlights will be required very soon if this continues. Here's John Clark. Mackay trying to prevent a United throw. He didn't make it. Gary Mackay ensuring that the referee has given the free kick, which was clearly unhappy about. Hearts bench there behind the ball. Joe Jordan and Frank Connor, the management team, both there. That's won by Levine. Here's Penny. Now pass tripped there by Miller. That's a good free kick taken very quickly indeed, but the referee wants to take action against John Miller before the free kick is taken. Well, this will be for persistent fouling. Miller was involved in a couple of very heavy early challenges on the player he's been delegated to mark this afternoon, Billy McKinley. But that trip on Morris Malpass is the one which has been the last straw as far as the referee is concerned. So first yellow card of the match for John Miller. David Neary. Clark helps it on. Levine clears it up. Ferguson's clearance this time. Here's McKinley trying to set that up for Bolan. First time cross from McKinley, and Bowman came in too close to Ferguson there. Referee letting play to continue. John Clark having caught well upfield. Jim McAnally's going back to help in defence. There he is. He couldn't get to that, but Alan Main did. Good piece of handling in dreadful conditions. And there was a collision there with John Robertson, which was completely accidental. It hasn't done Alan Main any good. Well, this long ball forward, Jim McAnally takes a lot of credit for being in that position, covering John Clark. But look here as Alan Main goes across. He was caught there by John Robertson's boot as he went past him. Picked up by McKinley for Hearts in midfield. Robertson makes the run wide, but John Clark is with him. There's Bowman. Clark. McKinley holding off Derek Ferguson. That's Duncan Ferguson. Took his eye off the ball. Perhaps expected Graham Hawke to be right on his back, which he wasn't. Yard on the defender. It's Ferguson again. Bowen breaking on the left. Testing the pace of McPherson and earning a corner kick. Has he? No. The referee says a goal kick. The last touch came off the youngster. He clearly doesn't agree. But showing a very good turn of pace, Gary Bowen, as he tried to go outside Dave McPherson. There's no slouch himself. Ireland's header. Touched on by Duncan Ferguson to French. That's a good turn. He's away from Levine and from Miller. Now Bowman. Makes the ball angled in. It's forced over the line by Duncan Ferguson. And Dundee United take the lead. The 37th minute of the match. It was delightfully set up by United. And no wonder those fans are so overjoyed. Hamish French played a key role in all this. But look at the quality of this ball, played in by Dave Bowman, tempting Henry Smith off his line. The tall figure there of Duncan Ferguson bundling the ball over the line. And the run plays it up the line. French will keep it in play. Looking for support. Bowman arrives on the right. He's used the decoy. Here's McKinley. And the free kick is given against Tosh McKinley for the body check. McKinley protesting bitterly that he's been the victim of so many fouls in the match so far. Louis Thau perhaps saying to the youngster, well, all I can do is give the free kicks and show yellow cards when appropriate. I don't think even McKinley would think that that was a yellow card offence. Great respect being shown there by Hearts for John Clark, shooting power. Gary Boland too is a very powerful striker of the ball. That came off the wall and will give United a corner kick. So for United, only the second corner kick in the match. John Miller, it's too high for Clark. A big fellow showing the confidence to take on Craig Levine, but he had quite enough space at the touchline. Back he goes to his defensive position, beside David Neary. Goes Van der Hoorn. Beautifully taken down by Ferguson. The dummy by McKinley didn't pay off. Van der Hoorn read it well. And McKinley has lost his right boot. Still prepared to challenge though. The referee, I think, will insist the boot is replaced. Finding Crab again. There's Penny. That's a good cross. John Robertson's there. Van der Hoorn's clearance finds Derek Ferguson. Fine effort by Ferguson. And very well handled by Alan Main once again. Got down quickly to make sure that his body behind that shot. Kick out there from Alan Main. Ends the first half, which the Hearts supporters will look back on and wonder how are they a goal behind, because it was Duncan Ferguson who popped up with that fine header after an excellent move created by Hamish French, and a beautiful cross delivered by Dave Bowman for the big striker there to bundle the ball past Henry Smith. That was after Hearts had dominated so much of the proceedings, but United defended extremely well. And half-time, Hearts are the team with lots of thinking to do. It's half-time, it's Hearts nil, Dundee United.
Sky Soccer Weekend, the show that gives you the most comprehensive look forward to the coming weekend's action. More background, more news, more interviews. More facts, more insight, more comment, more topics, more action. Friday night at 6, updated at 10, only on Sky Sports.
sport isn't greed.
What is wrong with you? Come on!
Sport isn't arrogance.
Let's go. Do your job.
Sport isn't big business. Sport isn't fashion. Sport isn't gimmicks. Sport isn't life and death. It's time to get back to what is essential.
Happiness is a cigar called Hamlet, the mild cigar.
Back in the 70s, The Joy of Sex was the book that broke all the rules. This week, Today newspaper brings you The New Joy of Sex, more sensual, more explicit. The New Joy of Sex is the loving guide for the 90s. Read The New Joy of Sex this week, only in Today.
The Stranglers. For the first time, all their greatest hits on one album. It includes No More Heroes, All Day and All of the Night, plus this, their biggest seller of all time.
Golden brown, texture like sun, lays me down with my mind she runs.
And Strange Little Girl.
Where are you going, Strange Little Girl?
Other hits include Peaches, Walk On By, and Duchess. Classic tracks from The Stranglers, their greatest hits.
You better watch out for the skin.
Incisive melodic rock, uniquely Stranglers.
There's always the sun. Always, always.
The Stranglers, their greatest hits.
Italian football. A chance to settle old scores. Sampdoria against Inter tonight at 10 on Sky Sports.
Wind has dropped for the second half of the match with United. Not too unhappy about that, I reckon, because any strong wind behind can be troublesome in itself. That ball still carrying away there from Hamish French to give Hearts a goal kick. Hamish French playing such a key role in that opening goal for Duncan Ferguson. Didn't see much of the ball in the first half, but that was a very important contribution. Martinelli holding off, but Ferguson got a touch there. That just made life difficult for the United player. Here's McKinley. That's great close control. He appeared to lose the ball for a second. Just carrying it too far ahead of him, allowing McPherson to step in neatly. So hard sweep and breaks. Well, the free kick's been given. He collided there with Van der Haan. He wants to get forward. That's why Derek Ferguson waits. This is Levine. Person battling there to find space away from Duncan Ferguson, the young striker again, all the way back to mark him. Well, such organisation once again in those United ranks. A long kick out there from Alan Main, carrying out for the throw to Hearts. Graham Hogg. Still to taste defeat in a league match for Hearts. Keeps it. There's McKinley. No Malpass. Looking around, assessing the options. Picks out Duncan Ferguson. Pass had to be accurate. Bolin was strong enough to resist the challenge from Mackay. And have a throw. Boland taking it short. He has perhaps the longest throw in the game in Scotland, but using well pass. Mary to Duncan Ferguson. The tackle came from Miller. This is Mackay. And a fine pass forward, just too quick for John Robertson. Well, the Hearts supporters warming to that bit of play and giving further encouragement to their favourites. By the line to Ferguson. And goes Hogg. Grab very quickly to the ball. Tackled firmly by McKinley. Miller uses Ferguson. Miller again taking up good position in midfield. Supported well by McPherson. This is McKinley. Ferguson again. And Mackay and Penny. That's kind of wing play. Hearts are hoping to see from Penny. McKinley had time there to turn and send the ball to safety. McPherson to Levine. There's Crabb. Now Derek Ferguson stepping away from McAnally. He's given that straight to Patalainen though. Good challenge made by Hawk quickly on Duncan Ferguson. Chance on for a break for United for a split second there. There's Mackay. Faced by Patalainen. Then by McKinley. Crabb caught there by McAnally. It's a free kick to Hearts. Hearts enjoying a lot of possession there, showing plenty of patience, keeping the discipline. Not resorting to any long hopeful balls upfield. Derek Ferguson over the free kick. Plus it goes to McKinley. That's well struck. Off the upright and cleared by Clark. Well, that's the closest yet from Hearts. And Alan Main was certainly beaten by that effort. So a free kick given there by referee Louis Thurber. What a moment that was for the Dundee United defence. The ball knocked sideways by Ferguson to the left foot of Tosh McKinley. He's wide of the wall now, thundering that beyond Alan Main, it's straight back off the post. Slightly misjudged in the air that by Clark, coming to no harm though. Here's Van der Hoorn. Now Bowman. Bowman's fighting for the ball again. And a little bit of a nasty exchange here. Tosh McKinley and Dave Bowman. Certainly not exchanging pleasantries. United bench there, Stuart Hogg, the sprint coach, on his feet, gesticulating. Dave Bowman being spoken to by referee Thau for his angry reaction to all that. Yellow card for Bowman. There will be something similar, I'm sure, for Tosh McKinley. No, it's not. It's simply a stern lecture. Free kick to Hearts. McPherson running it across. There's Hogg in the thick of it all. Playing that dangerously across the face of goal. It's kept in play by Penny. That's good sleight of foot by Penny initially, but the reactions of Boland were quick enough to make the tackle. And the corner kick it is. Boland really believed the ball had gone out before he had to make that tackle. Derek Ferguson. Headed away by Bowman. Dave Bowman, of course, a former Hearts player. Began his career here. Here's Ferguson. Crabb. Penny taking on Malpass. Cross there for Mackay. That's a good effort. Well saved by Mayne. Because that was really good goalkeeping to hold that ball, which must be like a bar of soap in these circumstances. Penny given that option by Gary Mackay's positioning. That was well struck. How about that for top-class goalkeeping? Lofting it forward, Ferguson gives chase, but Hogg will get there ahead of him, and Henry Smith makes sure there's no mistake. Just past the midway point in the second half. Hart still trying to find a way through this well-organised United defence. There's Duncan Ferguson screening the ball from Hart, but losing out to Derek Ferguson. John Clark. Header well controlled by Derek Ferguson. It's hustled all the way though by McAnally. Here's Bowman now. Well, Bowman looking for one of the strikers to come across to that side of the field. Penny holding off Malpass, helped by Miller. Mackay came off Bolland for the throw to Hearts. Been playing that into space, filled only by John Robertson. So dangerous here. Here's Mackay. Great chance now. It's brilliantly saved, but there's McKinley. And Hearts have equalised. Joy for McKinley, and perhaps justice done after his fine effort came off the post a short time ago. But John Robertson made this possible. Great leading of the attack there, setting up Gary Mackay, who brought out that fine save from Alan Mayne, and entitled to feel very disappointed that the ball broke to Tosh McKinley. Well, that goal coming in the 25th minute of the second half, and coming at a time when it looked as though Dundee United were looking very composed and comfortable on the lead. And that has brought the Hearts fans to life. Here's Gary Boland lofting it inside. Person coming up with a header. John Clark getting instructions from Alan Mayne. Well, the patient probing of Hearts has paid off. Ferguson getting up there with Patalainen, trying to go on the end of his header. This is Crabb. Now Hogg. Goes down rapidly by Billy McKinley. So the throw being left to John Miller. Pass back. There's Gary Boland picking the ball up from Penny. McAnally to McKinley. This is Clark. Ariel Roots again looking for Duncan Ferguson. Ferguson taking no risk there for the pass back. Captain. Inspire his teammates towards victory. Head flick on there, but the referee has given the free kick to Hearts. He didn't like the aerial challenge there. John Clark, I think, penalised. Derek Ferguson and Gary Mackay having a discussion. Ferguson makes his way into the penalty box. Kinley available again on the left. That's for McPherson. There's Crabb. Chances on again in front of goal. United defence this time reacting quickly enough to close round the Hearts strikers. And it's turned away by Patalainen, and suddenly United look a little bit ragged at the back. Well, we've said it so often before, but it's remarkable how a goal transforms the run of the game. There's Crabb back with Mackay again. Well, Gary Mackay conducting almost a one-man campaign to get that ball beyond Alan Main. Such a good dig in that right foot, Mackay. And that ball came into the channel for him. He went on and strike it towards the near post. It was just about a foot wide. Together some attacking thoughts again. They have to win the match. Extreme pressure from Levine. There's Bowman getting the ball away from McKinley, but no real effect for United. And the result of all that activity, Jim McLean has now arrived in the Dundee United dugout. Clearly concerned about run of the game. He's joined Paul Sturrock on the bench. Here's Mackay running at Malpass, going on his left foot this time. Well, such splendid attacking play once again from Gary Mackay. Three good efforts recently with his right foot, but showing his two-footedness now, coming inside Malpass, rifling in that shot with the left foot just wide of the target. Lofted forward by Miller. Pulling that into space, hoping to find Ferguson. That's good play by Penny, but Robinson is offside. Trying to work that front line to the best effect. John Robertson caught it a couple of times with the offside flag. Patalainen helps that on for Ferguson. The bicular aim for McAnally. And the challenge was made well by Derek Ferguson. McAnally again surging forward, such tireless energy in the middle of the field for United. That could so easily have been the leading goal. The back killer on Ferguson setting up McAnally, and he was challenged at the right time by Ferguson. Robertson did well again, but it is going to be a draw in the end, the final whistle blown by referee Thau. And on the balance of play overall, I reckon that is just about fair. United survived the first half onslaught extremely well, then went ahead through Duncan Ferguson. Hearts were unlucky when Tosh McKinley drilled one against the post, but then picked up a goal when John Robertson and Gary Mackay combined to set up Tosh McKinley's equaliser. It's Hearts 1, Dundee United 1.
Your 1 year here almost exactly, Joe. Would you consider that year as successful as you'd wanted it to be?
Well, it depends how you judge success. Success, obviously, I'd like to win something, and I think it's always gauged with that. But I think there has certainly been an improvement. I think if you ask the players and the people around about it, I think that when I came, things were certainly down, and the confidence was down. And it has taken time, but I think there has been an improvement. And we as individuals at the club have got to improve, and collectively, I'm sure that we will improve. And if we do that, I think we're in with a chance.
And have you enjoyed yourself here?
It's been hard, and there's still a long way to go. But I'm enjoying being in Scotland, and my family's here, and everything at this particular moment, I can't complain. Where we are at this moment, I don't think anybody could complain.
Now, you're top of the league at the moment and looking full of confidence. What's the big difference at Tynecastle this season?
Well, the manager's really got us tactically aware, not just about our game, but about other teams as well. So, I mean, we're really tuned in now, and everything's really going really well.
Is there a feeling in the dressing room the Hearts could really win something this season?
Well, it's early doors, Jock. You know, I think we've only played 8 games, not including Skull Cup ties. But up until now, I mean, if you're at the top of the league, I'd rather be the top than the bottom. So everything's going well just now.
I bet it is. So Hearts hanging in there at the top. Boy, what an afternoon for football, wasn't it? I really feel sorry for the fans who turned out in all weather onto those open terraces. Still, there's lots to enjoy from the game, and once again, the promising youngster Duncan Ferguson showed us his goal-scoring ability. It really was a fine header. It was a fine goal from two counts, actually. Watch the cross. David Bowman bends in a wonderful cross. Now, Duncan Ferguson knows he's getting clattered, but he keeps his eye on the ball, he goes in bravely, and he gets his reward. But to be fair to Hearts, they kept at it, kept their composure, and this was a wonderful goal for the build-up. John Robertson links up with Gary Mackay, and this is where you feel sorry for Alan Main. He wants a bit of luck here. He wants that to be one of his defenders. It's not. It's Tosh McKinley, and it's 1-1. And perhaps Tosh McKinley will think justice has been done, because this is what happened just a little bit earlier. So a point each means Hearts stay top. Celtic got an early fright at Parkhead when Airdrie took the lead through Kenny Black, but Joe Miller equalised, and after Airdrie had Jimmy Boyle sent off, Celtic went on to clinch victory with goals from Mike Galloway and a Charlie Nicholas penalty.